Hello everyone, and welcome back to Liftoff. For years now, SpaceX has been working towards one goal, launching the Starship rocket, which is said to be the most powerful rocket ever built. The Starship rocket has already gone through some testing, but there is one main test that remains to figure out whether it's truly ready for interplanetary travel. This is the first ever orbital test flight. It's expected to happen sometime soon, but there are a lot of factors that are causing its delay. One of these factors is that SpaceX has to get a launch license from the FAA. But before they can be awarded the launch license, there's a lot that is dependent on it. By the looks of things, the FAA has put SpaceX a step further. In addition to that, SpaceX has also been working on their launch tower, which seems to be taking shape right now. We might just see the launch sooner than expected, but what's really going on? Before we go any further, please take a moment to leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more updates on Elon Musk, space, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more. And with that, let's find out more about the launch tower under construction. Before we can head over to the launch tower, let's first find out the FAA's decision. Before the FAA can grant SpaceX the license to launch the Starship rocket, they have set some milestones that SpaceX has to complete. One of these includes SpaceX taking more than 75 actions to ensure that the environmental effects of the flying gigantic 40-story tall Starship rocket are kept to a bare minimum. This rocket is said to be launched from South Texas. However, regulators later stated that the launch would have no significant consequences. This definitely moved SpaceX a step closer to getting its launch license from the agency. The FAA gave a statement regarding this, and it said that SpaceX will need to take actions to mitigate environmental impacts from its proposed plan to launch the Starship Super Heavy vehicle from Boca Chica, Texas. SpaceX was happy when they heard the news, and to share the excitement with its followers, they tweeted, "One step closer to the first orbital flight test of the Starship." However, with this decision, SpaceX still has a lot of work to do to ensure that they have reduced the possible damage to the environment at the Boca Chica site. This is mainly because this launch site is located near state parks and a wildlife refuge on the South Texas coast, which is east of Brownsville. Now, SpaceX has a roadmap to clear a major regulatory hurdle that has prevented it from proceeding with full-scale test flights of the largest and most powerful rocket in the world. According to the FAA's FELA Programmatic Environmental Assessment of SpaceX's Starship launch operations in Texas, SpaceX plans would not really have a significant impact on the local environment. This is even with the fact that they have more than 75 mitigation measures that are pending, some of which the space company has already completed. The measures that the FAA requires of SpaceX include ongoing monitoring of vegetation and wildlife in the area that is around the Starship facility, which SpaceX calls Starbase. In addition to that, SpaceX will also have to notify the surrounding communities of potential engine noise and sonic booms that are expected to come from the launches. Not only that, but SpaceX has to give more advance notice of launches so that they can reduce the time that a public highway that passes through the Starbase facility is closed when they're carrying out their launch operations. It has been said that road closures will not be allowed on 18 identified holidays. Furthermore, weekend restrictions will only be allowed about 5 weekends per year, which will ensure that the local residents can access the wildlife refuge and the beach near the Starbase launch site. SpaceX is also expected by the FAA to work hand-in-hand with state or federal agencies to ensure that they have removed all launch debris from sensitive habitats. SpaceX will also have to minimize the lighting at the launch complex so they can reduce the impact on wildlife and the nearby beach. Even though the FAA has completed its environmental review, this is just one milestone on the road to SpaceX's first ever Starship orbital test flight. SpaceX has not yet been issued a launch license by the FAA, though. Apart from the environmental impact considerations, the FAA has said that it also considers public safety issues as an overflight of populated areas and payload content. The FAA is also considering national security or foreign policy concerns and insurance requirements for the launch operator before issuing a permit or license. In addition to obtaining a launch license from the FAA, SpaceX still has to complete the technical preparations for the Starship test flight. To achieve this, SpaceX has been working on the Texas launch pad. For the past year now, the company has made a lot of progress on this launch pad, as well as testing the numerous upgraded Raptor engines. These are the engines that will be used to power the rocket, they've been under testing to ensure that they overcome reliability and performance problems. When do you think the FAA will award the launch license to SpaceX for the Starship rocket? Do you think it'll be sometime in the next month or longer than that? Let us know in the comments section below. The Starship, which is made of nothing but pure stainless steel, is said to be the most powerful rocket ever to fly. The Super Heavy, which is the first stage of the Starship rocket, is powered by 33 methane-fueled Raptor 2 engines that together will produce about 17 million pounds of thrust at liftoff. The rocket is also made so that it can be used over and over again. Both the Super Heavy booster and the Starship can return to Earth and land vertically on the launch pad before taking off again. Not so long ago, the second section of the Florida launch tower for the SpaceX's huge Super Heavy and Starship rocket was lifted on top of the first tower segment at the Kennedy Space Center. This is a continuation of the structure that is set to stand as high as 400 feet. Last week, SpaceX was seen transporting the second metal tower segment, which alone is as tall as a five-story building. This segment was being transported from a staging and construction site at the company's Robert Road at the Kennedy Space Center facility to Launch Complex 39A. After that, a large crane at Pad 39A was seen lifting the second tower section onto the lower segment. The first segment of the launch tower was transported to Pad 39A on June 15th, but it was installed on the tower's foundation on Monday last week. There are two more segments that are expected to be rolled out after the second one, and they're both visible at the Roberts Road property, which is where SpaceX is fabricating individual sections of the Starship pad before they move it to Pad 39A. The Starship launch pad being erected in Florida is said to resemble the tower that SpaceX built last year in Boca Chica, Texas, where the Starship will be launching from. The launch pad tower that is being constructed at Pad 39A is located about 1,000 feet, which is about 300 meters, east of the same location where SpaceX launches the Falcon 9 and Falcon Heavy rockets that carry satellites and astronauts into orbit. The Starbase pad at Kennedy will be similar to the launch site in Texas in that it will not have a flame trench. Over the coming weeks, SpaceX is expected to move more of the tower segments to Pad 39A as it works to complete the structural buildup of the Starship pad. During this entire period, other teams will have already moved propellant tanks and other support equipment. Once the tower has been fully assembled, the construction crews will then work to install the arms that will be used to stack the Starship on top of the Super Heavy booster. According to SpaceX, the arms will be used to catch the Super Heavy booster, which is about 30 feet wide, as it comes back to Earth to make its landing. The hardware for the arms, which SpaceX is calling chopsticks, was seen arriving at the Kennedy Space Center last week. With all the progress that SpaceX is making, we might just see the first orbital test flight of the Starship take place in about a month or so. Elon Musk, CEO and founder of SpaceX, even tweeted on June 14th about this, saying, "Starship will be ready to fly next month. I was in the High Bay and Mega Bay last night reviewing progress." In yet another tweet recently, he said, "We will have a second Starship ready to fly in August and then monthly thereafter." So it's clear that we might see a couple of launches of the Starship super rocket taking place this year. This is bound to change the history of rockets forever, and it is definitely a huge milestone for the company and Elon Musk as well. When do you think the first orbital launch of the Starship will take place? Feel free to let us know in the comment section below. Also, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to our channel for more updates on Elon Musk, SpaceX, Tesla, science, technology, and so much more. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.